Kamau, I was wondering if you picked up on this during your travels for your show here on CNN United Shades of America. I was thrilled you were able to join us because you've been traveling to so many states for the series. Have you picked up on what Tim is describing here?
I mean, you know, America was built on racial anxiety, so it's no surprise that it's still here right now. And I think the thing we try to do with the show is actually have conversations with people and not just shout slogans at them the way Trump is doing. And I think that if you get to have conversations with people, you can reach sometimes a new level of understanding or at least making more space for the humanity. But Trump is capitalizing on people's most base fears.
Why do you think, if that's the case, let's take that as true for a moment, if you believe it. Why do you think we don't hear it more often here on television? Why don't we read about it more often? Why isn't it a more integrated part of the analysis about Trump's rise to the GOP nomination?
I mean, I'll take that one.
Yeah, I'm sorry. That's what I meant. Yeah.
And then I'll pass it lovingly back to Tim. Thanks for bringing the facts and figures. I appreciate that, Tim. But yeah, America's always afraid of a race conversation. Not all of America. I mean, if you read Jamelle Bouie or TheRoot.com, there's lots of media covering it. But mainstream media, which is in large part owned by white people, is always afraid of a honest and open race conversation.
You point out that the mainstream media, yes, is mostly run by white men. And I wonder, you know, if there's something here about why networks don't have full-time race and ethnicity correspondents on TV, and why there's relatively small coverage of these topics in mainstream media. Certainly, I would say your show is part of the solution to this. But are there other recommendations you have as someone who lives this every day, who thinks about these issues for your program?
I mean, I think, you know, maybe it'd be great to have a race conciliation person in everybody's office. But you also just need more people of color and more LGBT and more different types of people. Because even on my show, United Shades of America, I was the only person of color on that show during production, which meant sometimes I would say things and everybody around me would look at me like I was crazy. And I'd be like, can I go get a black person to step into the room right now so you guys know I'm not crazy? And I think it's not just about having one person. It's about having a bunch of different types of people. There's more ideas in the room because that's when you get great ideas. You don't get great ideas from everybody when everybody's the same. You get great ideas when everybody's different, has different ideas.